Hello, I'm Dr. Priyamvada Shah. I'm a senior obstetrician and gynecologist. My special area of interests are high-risk pregnancy, infertility, and laparoscopic surgery. I am currently practicing at Cloudnine Hospital, Pimple, Saudagar, Pune. Let's discuss today a very important topic, PCOS or Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome. Nowadays, this is called as modern era disease or very commonly found in young individuals right from the adolescent. The causes are multifactorial. However, one could be genetically predisposed to have this PCOS. Most common cause thought is the hormonal imbalance, whether the increased weight gain causes the hormonal imbalance or hormonal imbalance causes the weight gain is a big question mark, but it becomes a cascade or a vicious cycle where obesity and PCOS goes hand in hand. Now, the patient can present with various symptoms, commonest being the menstrual problems, where the periods are very infrequent. She may not get periods every 2, 3, 4, 6 months, and patient has increased weight recently or in last few years, and she has observed that menses has become irregular. Basically, why her periods are irregular? Because she is not ovulating. So if the egg doesn't ovulate, it forms a cyst. When such multiple cysts are seen in the ovary, it is called as polycystic ovary, and it is commonly diagnosed by doing the ultrasound. So a chronic anovulation or long-term irregular periods is the cause and effect of PCOS. Another set of symptoms which patient has are because of the excess of androgens. So that could be acne or pimples, excess of facial hair growth, excess of hair growth on breast and the abdominal portion. This could be also the additional feature. Insulin resistance is also known in PCOD girls, where typically we see black discoloration around the nape of the neck and along the folds like axilla. These are suggestive of insulin resistance, and often we have to do certain tests to rule out the insulin resistance and pre-diabetic stage. Now coming back to the diagnosis, with sonography, it is diagnosed very easily. PCOS, in the PCOS, ovaries show multiple cysts arranged in periphery of the ovary like a garland. So often it is over-diagnosed also. If the patient has regular periods, we do not really treat this PCOD. With the sonography, once the diagnosis is made, we ask the patient to undergo certain investigations, which would be the hormonal investigations, which are blood tests, and certain tests to rule out the insulin resistant and the pre-diabetic condition. Now, long-term implications of PCOS are, it could be associated with increased risk of cancers in endometrial cavity, diabetes, and in pregnancy complications. Hence, as soon as possible, the PCOS should be treated. The treatment includes weight loss, regular exercise, lifestyle changes, dietary modification, and if the couple is opting for pregnancy, then we do have certain medications with which we can start the ovulation and couple can conceive. However, one can start preventing the PCOS by following a healthy lifestyle and keeping the weight in control by doing a regular exercise and eating healthy pattern of the food.